Okay, Michael, so this notion of having different features or different dimensions throw us off has a name, and it's called the curse
of dimensionality.
Ooh, nice audio effect.
I did like that audio effect in post-production. And it refers to, well, a very particular thing. So let me just read out what it refers to. As the number of features, or equivalently, dimensions, grows, that is, as we add more and more features, we go x sub 1, x sub 2, then we add x sub 3, and add more and more of these features. As those features grow, or as the number of dimensions grow, the amount of data that we need to generalize accurately also grows exponentially. Now, this is a problem, of course, because exponentially means bad in computer science land, because when things are exponential, they're effectively untenable. You sort of can't win.
I think everybody knows that, in the sense that if you look, I've done this experiment actually. If you look in the popular press, like Time Magazine or New York Times, USA Today, people will use the word exponentially sometimes to mean exponentially and sometimes to mean a lot.
Yeah, that's actually a pet peeve of mine, the whole notion
of,
oh, it's exponentially bigger. No, that's not meaningful. If you're saying I have one point and then I have another point and I want to say this point is exponentially bigger than this one, that's meaningless. It's also linearly bigger than that one.
Yeah,
exponential
again, I think
refers to a trend.
They're not talking about the mathematical relationship. They just mean a lot.
Okay, so they're wrong and it bothers me deeply. But I'm willing to accept it for the purposes of this discussion, okay? Exponentially means bad. It means that we need more and more and more and more data as we add features and dimensions. Now, as a machine learning person, this is a real problem, right? Because what you want to do, or like sort of what your instinct tells you to do is, oh, we've got this problem, we've got a bunch of data, we're not sure what's important, so why don't we just keep adding more and more and more features. So, we've got all these sensors and we'll just add this little bit and this little bit and we'll keep track of GPS location and we'll see the time of the day and we'll just keep adding stuff and then we'll figure out which ones are important. But the curse of dimensionality says that every time you add another one of these features, you add another dimension to your input space, you're going to need exponentially more data as you add those features in order to be able to generalize accurately. This is a very serious problem, and it sort of captures a little bit of what the difficulties are in KNN. If you have a distance function or a similarity function that assumes that everything is relevant or equally relevant or important, and some of them aren't, you're going to have to see a lot of data before you can figure that out, sort of before it washes itself away.
That makes a lot of sense.
Yeah, it seems a little scary. So, I think you can say these words, and the words sort of make sense, but I think it helps to kind of draw a picture, and so I'm going to draw a little picture, okay?
Yeah.
All right.